Hello everyone, hope you all are doing good. In this video, we will learn, read and understand the chapter Expert Detectives by Sharda Dwivedi, chapter 6 of class 7 book Honeycomb. Children are basically curious by nature. Whenever they see or get something new, they want to know everything about it. In this chapter, we have siblings Nishad and Maya who suspect one Mr. Nath. And they want to know a lot of things about Mr. Nath. What do they explore about him? Let's read in the chapter, Expert Detectives. Before you read, Nishad, a boy of 7, also called 7 because his name means the 7th note on the musical scale, and his 10-year-old sister Maya are very curious about one Mr. Nath. Then one day, the children's marble rolls into Mr. Nath's room and Nishad gets a chance to see him. Is he a crook on the run? Why is his face badly scarred? Why has he no friends? Nishad's mother, a doctor, knows Mr. Nath as a patient who is very polite. So Nishad is a boy of 7 years. He is also called 7 because the meaning of his name is the 7th note on musical scale. And he has a 10-year-old sister Maya. They are very curious about a person named Mr. Nath. Then one day, their marble rolled into Mr. Nath's room and they got a chance to see Mr. Nath. Is he a criminal? Why there are scars on his face? Why he has no friends? There are so many questions in these students' mind. Whereas their mother, who is a doctor and Mr. Nath is her patient, thinks that Mr. Nath is very polite. Now let's read the chapter, Expert Detectives, Part 1. As we walked back towards the clinic, 7 said, "He doesn't look anything like a monster, Maya. But did you see how thin he is? Maybe he is very poor and can't afford to eat." Maya is the narrator of the chapter. Here, Nishad and Maya are talking. So as they were walking back towards their mother's clinic, 7, that means Nishad, he said, "He doesn't look like a monster, Maya." So they are talking about Mr. Nath and Nishad is saying that to him, he doesn't look like a monster. He doesn't look bad at all. "And did you see how thin he is?" Nishad thinks that he is very thin and he is poor and he can't afford to eat. He is because he doesn't have money to pay for the food. "He can't be poor if he is a crook on the run," I told him. On that, Maya replied that he can't be poor if he is a crook on the run. Crook on the run means criminal, a cheat or criminal who is hiding. "He's probably got millions of rupees stashed away somewhere in that room." Stashed away means hidden away. And Maya also thinks that he has millions of rupees which is hidden in his room. "Do you really think he's a criminal, Maya?" "He doesn't look like one." Nishad looked doubtful. Nishad didn't believe Maya and he asked, "Do you really think he is a criminal because he doesn't look like a criminal?" "Of course he is one, 7, I said. "And he certainly isn't starving." Starving means suffering or dying from hunger. So Maya is sure he is a criminal and he is not at all starving or dying because of hunger. "Mr. Mehta told us that Ramesh brings his meal up from the restaurant downstairs." Mr. Mehta told them that Ramesh, a boy who works in the restaurant, always takes his food from the restaurant which is downstairs. "But Maya, Mr. Mehta told us he doesn't work anywhere. So how can he possibly have money to pay for the food?" Nishad said. On that, Nishad doubted that Mr. Mehta also told us that he doesn't work anywhere. So how can he pay for the food? "Exactly," I exclaimed. "He must have lots of money hidden somewhere. Maybe in that trunk in his room. It's probably full of silver and gold and jewels." So on that, Maya said, "Exactly, if he doesn't work, then how can he pay? So probably he has lot of money which is hidden in the trunk, in the box in his room, and it's probably full of silver, gold and other jewels." "What rubbish," Nishad interrupted. But Nishad doesn't believe Maya, so he interrupted. "I know I'm right, stupid," I told him. "By the way, 7, did you see his scars? Scars are marks that are left on the face because of a wound, burn or any other thing." So Maya said, "Did you see the scars on his face?" "I couldn't, it was dark, but I bet he got them during a shootout with the police or something." And Maya also said that, "I couldn't see the scars because it was dark. So probably he got it during a shootout, during an encounter with police." Mummy told us clearly they were Burns cars, Nishad said firmly. So Nishad said, Mama told us that it was Burns car. Perhaps the police had to get his house on fire to force him out, I suggested. Seven looked unsure. On that, Maya said that maybe the police had to fire his house, set his house on fire so that he gets out of the house. Nishad was not sure about it. On the Monday following Mama's birthday, Seven went alone with her to the clinic at Girgaon as I was spending the evening with a school friend. When they returned, Nishad told me he had been to see Mr. Nath and I felt most annoyed that I hadn't been there. So on the Monday, the next day to their mother's birthday, Seven went to the clinic alone because Maya had to spend the evening with one of her school friends. And when they returned, Nishad told Maya that he had got a chance to see Mr. Nath. On that, Maya was annoyed, that means irritated, that she couldn't get the chance. Seven had been quite upset about Mr. Nath's gaunt appearance. Gaunt means thin and exhausted, tired, and was sure that he was starving. He told me that he had knocked loudly on Mr. Nath's door that evening and said, "Open the door quickly, Mr. Nath." The man had opened it and asked him, "Lost another marble?" So Seven was quite upset about Mr. Nath's thin and exhausted appearance, and he was sure that Mr. Nath was starving. And he knocked on Mr. Nath's door. When he opened, Mr. Nath said, "Did you lose another marble?" He had obviously recognized my brother. So Mr. Nath obviously recognized Nishad, probably because he has seen Nishad in their mother's clinic. "No," said Nishad. He had taken the man's hand in his own and thrust a bar of chocolate into it. So Nishad said, "No, I haven't lost the marble." And he pulled Mr. Nath's hand and pushed a bar of chocolate in his hand as he thinks that Mr. Nath is starving. "Did you get a chance to peek into the trunk, Seven?" I asked. So Maya asked, "Did you get a chance to look into the trunk?" Nishad looked disappointed. "He didn't even ask me in," he said. Then he smiled. "But I did find out something, Maya. I went down to the restaurant where Ramesh works and talked to him." So Nishad appeared disappointed because Mr. Nath did not even tell him to come inside. But then he smiled because he said that, "I have found something important from Ramesh." "Good for you, Mr. Detective," I said, patting him on the back. "I hope you question him properly." Seven looked pleased. "Ramesh told me that he takes two meals for Mr. Nath every morning and evening and two cups of tea." So Maya was happy that Nishad has got information from Ramesh. And then Seven said that Ramesh takes two meals for him every day, one in the morning and one in the evening, and two cups of tea, that too, one in the morning and one in the evening. Ramesh says he is not very particular about what he eats. It's always the same food, two chapatis, some dal and vegetable. Mr. Nath pays cash and tips well. So this was the information Seven got about from Ramesh about Mr. Nath, that he takes two meals and two cups of tea every day, and he's not very particular about what he eats. He eats the same food every day, two chapatis, some dal and vegetable. And Mr. Nath always pays in cash and tips, also gives good tips. "Ramesh told me something very strange, Maya," Seven added. "Almost every Sunday, he carries two lunches to Mr. Nath's room, and the same man is with him each time. He's tall, fair, stout, and wears spectacles. Ramesh says his visitor talks a lot, unlike Mr. Nath, who hardly speaks. He also got additional information that every Sunday, he carries two lunches for Mr. Nath because there is same man with him every Sunday. He's tall, fair, stout. Stout means little fat, and wears spectacles. And he's not like Mr. Nath, who doesn't talk a lot. His visitor talks a lot." "Well done, Nishad," I told him. "Now that we have made some progress with our inquiries, we'll have to sort out all the facts like expert detectives so that we can trap the crook." So Maya was happy. She said, "Now we have got so much information, we have to put it properly. We have to sort out all the facts to catch the criminal, trap the crook, catch the criminal." "How you do go on, Maya?" Seven sighed. "How can you possibly imagine he's crook? He looks so ordinary." So Seven was not ready to believe Maya. He said, "How can you go on like this? How can you think that he's a crook? He looks so ordinary." "Criminals can look quite ordinary, Smarty," I retorted. So Maya retorted. That means she scolded or she opposed Nishad and she said that criminals can look ordinary. Did you see the picture of the Hyderabadi housebreaker in the papers yesterday? He looked like any man on street. Nishad looked doubtful. Then she gave example of Hyderabadi criminal who housebreakers, the criminal who break the house yesterday, which came in the paper, and he also looked so ordinary. Nishad looked doubtful on that. The monsoon break that broke the next day. Dark clouds accompanied by blinding flashes of lightning and roaring rolls of thunder burst with all their fury. Fury means anger. Flooded the street with a heavy downpour. School was to have reopened after the summer holidays, but no traffic could move through the flooded roads and there was an unexpected holiday. So next day there was an unexpected holiday because there was heavy downpour, heavy rain, and there was thunder, there was lightning, and streets were flooded with water. There was a lot of water where vehicles cannot move. So that is why there was an unexpected holiday. I thought I'd spend the time usefully. I sat at my desk in our bedroom with a sheet of paper before me. So Maya thought she will use this time, and she sat in her bedroom with a sheet of paper in front of her. Now let's see part second. I wrote in large block letters, catching a crook, expert detectives Nishad and Maya Pandit, by appointment to the whole world. So Maya started jotting down facts about Mr. Nath, and she gave a heading, catching a crook, expert detectives Nishad and Maya, by appointment too. That means to be officially chosen. They are officially chosen to catch the crook by the whole world, for the whole world. Then I began writing. About half an hour later, I turned towards Seven, who was laying on his tummy, chin cupped in his palms, reading comics. Want to hear what I have written? I asked. So she jotted down points about Mr. Nath, and then she turned to Nishad to ask, do you want to hear what I have written? He looked up questioningly. I have listed all the facts we know about Mr. Nath, which might help us to trap him, I said. Want to hear? Seven nodded. So Seven agreed to listen to Maya. She had written some fact about Mr. Nath. Fact number one, I read, his name is Mr. Nath. We must discover his first name. Do you think that's his real name, Maya? Nishad asked. So therefore, Maya's first fact was that his name, they only know him by Mr. Nath. They don't know his first name. On that, Nishad doubted. Do you think that's his real name? Probably not, I said. Most crooks have an alias. I added a big question mark after Nath. Alias is the other name by which a person is known. Fact number two, I read on. The tenants at Shankar House says he's mad, strange and unfriendly. Tenant are people who live on rent. So she said that the tenant who live in Shankar House, they say that he's very strange, he's mad and he's not friendly. Number three, he doesn't talk to anyone and is mannerless. But he did talk to us, Maya, and Mama says he's very polite, Nishad interrupted. On that, Nishad interrupted when Maya said that he is mannerless and he doesn't talk to anyone. So Nishad said, but Mama told us that he is polite and he do talk to us. He only talked to us because he had to, I said. And since he was under Mama's medical treatment, he had to be polite. So Maya said that he only talked to us once and because he had to. And since Mama is treating him, he has to be polite in front of her and us. Fact number four, he doesn't receive any letter. Seven noted. Seven agreed to his fact that he doesn't receive any letter. Number five, he has been living in room 10 for of Shankar House for more than a year, I continued. So number five was that he is living in that room for more than a year. Number six, he doesn't work and sits in his room all day. Number seven, the kids in Shankar House and even some of the grown-ups are scared of him. So the fact was he doesn't go anywhere to work and kids and even grown-ups are scared of him. Number 8, he has no visitors except for a spectacled fair fat man who visits him on Sundays for lunch. And number 9, food and tea are taken to his room by Ramesh from the restaurant downstairs. He doesn't care what he eats. He pays bill immediately and tips well. That ends my list. Have I forgotten anything, Seven? So she made 9 points in her list, including that he doesn't go anywhere to work, food and tea are taken to him, he has no visitor, and tenants are scared of him. So she asked Nishad, have I forgotten anything? Nishad had obviously not been paying too much attention to my list of facts, All he could say was, poor man Maya, he must be so lonely if he doesn't have any friends. So Nishad was not paying attention to his sister. In fact, he was just thinking that he's so lonely, he has no friends. How can a crook have friends, idiot? I almost shouted. On that, Maya got irritated and she shouted, how can a crook have friends? At least he has one friend, the one who meets him on Sundays, said Nishad. Then Nishad said that, thank God he has one friend, the one who comes on Sunday. A brilliant thought occurred to me just then. That man must be Mr. Nath's accomplice in crime. Accomplice is partner. I said, maybe he keeps all the loot and he comes now and then to give part to his partner. Then a brilliant thought came to Maya's mind, that probably the person who comes to meet him every Sunday is his partner in crime, and he has all the money of loot and he comes every Sunday to give him his part. Mr. Nath for expenses, that's it, I'm sure I'm right. If you insist on calling him a criminal, I don't think I want to discuss anything with you, Maya, said Nishad angrily. He can't be such a bad man if he gives Ramesh such generous tips. Generous means kind and large tips. So he said that if you keep calling him criminal, I don't want to discuss anything on this. And he can't be a bad man because he gives such nice tips to Ramesh. Probably Ramesh knows something about his past, so Mr. Nath must be bribing him to keep quiet. On that, Maya again doubted that probably Ramesh is also his partner and he knows something about his past. That is why he is bribing Ramesh. Nishad glared at me with his arms tightly crossed across his chest. I was beginning to get fed up with him. So Nishad, with his arms closed, continuously stared at Maya, and Maya was getting irritated now, fed up with him. How can we make any progress with our investigation if you take such attitude, Seven? I asked. She said that how can we progress in our investigation if you take such attitude about Mr. Nath? I'll cooperate only if you give up this idea about him being an escape crook, said Seven. You really make me angry. So Seven said that, okay, I will cooperate only if you don't call him criminal again and again. I almost hit him. I make you angry, you stupid oaf. Oaf is a man who is rough or clumsy or who is unintelligent. Maya was getting angry. I shouted, you make me mad. What is the point of all these inquiries if he is not a crook? If you think he is a nobody, what's the idea of bothering about him? Please tell me. So Maya said that what is the point of making all these inquiries if he thinks he is not a crook? Why should we bother about him? Nishad looked thoughtful. I'd like to find out why he's so thin and why he's so lonely. I want to know why he doesn't have any friends and lives alone. So Nishad is not ready to consider that he is criminal. In fact, he wants to know why he is so thin and lonely and why he has no friends. Try to understand, Seven, I told him. If he's lived in Shankar House for a year and hasn't made a single friend, there's something wrong. He's obviously scared that someone will recognize him and give him up to the cops. On that, Maya explained that try to understand, if he's living in that place for almost a year and he has no friends, then obviously there is something fishy. He thinks that somebody will recognize him, know him, and give him to the police, to the cops. Maybe no one's tried to make friends with him, Nishad protested. So Nishad again protested. He said maybe nobody tried to make friends with him. Why should anyone bother? You have seen what a nasty bear he is. Nasty means irritating. Then Maya said, then why would anybody want to make friends with him? He's such an annoying person. I don't care, said Nishad stubbornly. I like him and I'm going to try to be friends with him, to be his friend. So Nishad is stubborn to be friends with him. And he said that I don't care what others think. Friends with a crook. Ha, you're crazy, Seven, I said. The cops will take you to jail with him. Do you want that to happen to you, idiot? Then Maya said that you want to be a friend with criminal? Do you want to go to jail along with him? Nishad merely glared at me and quietly walked out of room. My theory seemed to have made no impression on him at all. But Nishad did not believe Maya. He just looked at Maya and went out of the room. And it seemed that Maya's theories had no effect on him at all. So this was the story by Sharda Dwivedi from her book The Broken Flute. So this is how Nishad and Maya investigated the case. Maya thinks that he is a criminal. Nishad thinks that he is a poor person. So did you like the story, students? Now tell me, what do you think about Mr. Nath? Is he really a criminal or he is just a nice person? Just do comment and let me know. Thank you for listening to the chapter, students. Bye bye for now.